sense to sense impressions. Most likely, unsociable animals have arrived at this primitive kind of communication, at least to a certain degree. A higher development is reached when further signs are introduced and understood, which establish the relation between those other signs designating sense impressions. At this stage, it is already possible to report somewhat complex series of impressions. We can see that language has come to existence. If language is to lead us all to understanding, there must be rules concerning the relation between the signs on the one hand, and on the other hand, there must be a stable correspondence between signs and impressions. In their childhood, individuals connected by the same language grasp these rules and relations mainly by intuition. When man becomes conscious of the rules concerning the relations between signs, the so-called grammar of language is established. In an early stage, the words may correspond directly to impressions. At a later stage, this direct connection is lost in as far as some words convey relations to perceptions only if used in connection with other words. For instance, such words are is or thing. And word groups either. Word groups that can single words refer to perception. When language becomes thus partially independent from the background of impressions, a greater inner coherence is gained. Only at this further development, where frequent use is made of so-called abstract concepts, language becomes an instrument of reasoning in the true sense of the word.